accounts on this whole app. And the reason why is because it's so satisfying to watch my friend over at Soft Washing Service, you know, pressure wash the outside of people's houses. And, you know, it's his job to pressure wash the outside, but it's the people's job to clean the inside of their house. And that's what Jesus says to the Pharisees one day, that he accuses them of just washing the outside of their life, just looking all good and fancy on the outside, but inside they had really dirty lives. And so Jesus was encouraging them to clean the inside too.
I told my husband to make one of those satisfying power washing videos. He did not understand the assignment. C minus. Two stars. I can do better than that. Let's see who's TikTok this better.
Hi, my name is John Viet and I own a pressure washing company in Tampa, Florida. Today you're going to see me cleaning some concrete. Don't forget to smash that like button if you find this satisfying. Now we're going to go ahead and lay our floor machine down and go back and forth in long streaks. This helps agitate all the dirt, mold, and mildew. If you want to see more content, go ahead and follow for more.
So most of you guys know this already, but I'm a crime and trauma scene cleaner. So trigger warning here is because today I'll be talking about suicide and my experience helping families overcome the aftermath of such traumatic events in their lives. So obviously this is not footage of the suicide cleaning I did this week. That's just out of respect for the family and the deceased. But I do want to talk broadly about this type of stuff because it's never really brought up, and I think it's an important thing to know. So what happened earlier this week was we got a call from a lady who was just sobbing on the phone. And the first thing she said to us was, "The police said I should call you guys." When we heard this, you know, we instantly knew that this was a trauma response and that she was still in a lot of shock at whatever had just happened. Once we found out that a death had occurred, we just stopped asking questions, because asking specific questions about what happened, especially for someone in such a vulnerable state, it can be very traumatic for them. So we stopped asking questions and we sent a guy out there right away. So once we got there to the scene, we met a friend of the deceased who was stepping up to help the family navigate this traumatic event in their life. And when you're talking to these people, you can just see the pain and suffering in their eyes as you speak with them, and it's just super hard. And so when we got there, he started showing us the scene, telling us the story of what had happened just then. And then he started asking about payment options and how he should go about paying us. And we basically just said, "Don't worry about that right now. The insurance company will handle everything for you, and you shouldn't have to worry about this yourself. What's important is that we get the scene cleaned up right away, because we cannot let the family see this and have them get re-traumatized." And then after that, we just get to work, and even though I've been doing it for so many years, you know, I've done suicide cleanups in the past, they're just still very emotionally taxing on me. You know, you feel for the family, you feel for the victim and everything that they went through, and yeah, it's just hard. You know, sometimes with these cleanups, you're cleaning up remains of the person on family photos. Sometimes you're disposing of items that they used for the last time that day. And basically what happens is, you can't help this, but you start piecing together some of the things they try to use to mask the pain. Oftentimes we see a lot of drug paraphernalia on these type of scenes. Sometimes we just see a lot of self-help content and video footage and books and that sort of stuff. And of course we see religious items and religious texts in the homes as well. So with these type of jobs, you always just have to remind yourself that it's better that I clean this up than having the family members try and do it themselves or stumble upon it. So yeah, that's just a little bit about what it's like being a crime and trauma scene cleaner. You know, sometimes you get to be part of really cool, ongoing, active investigations. Other times you're cleaning a suicide where you can hear the mother crying in the other room. But there's a whole lot I could talk about when it comes to this type of stuff, so make sure to ask questions in the comments. And if you guys want to hear more about this type of stuff, just let me know. Thanks.